Hey guys, welcome back to the video. With the release of Lightyear, we officially have 26 Pixar movies. So in this video, I'm going to be ranking all of them. I want to mention this right off the gate. I did not review Lightyear just because I felt like I had nothing really critical to say about the movie. You guys will see in this video, but I actually liked the movie a lot. Before we get into videos and you're new, make sure to subscribe button, notifications on so you don't miss anytime I open a video or I go live. Also, comment your ranking for the Pixar movies down below. Both wasting more time, let's get into it. So as you guys can see here, the 5 twos that we have are bad, meh, good, great, and best of the best. So starting it off with A Bug's Life, I'm gonna put A Bug's Life at meh. I haven't seen this one in a very, very long time, so I don't really want to put it at good. I think at minimum I can put it at good, but I definitely feel like it, from what I remember, it's definitely a more meh movie. I definitely want to rewatch it sometime soon because it's one of the few movies on this list that I haven't really seen in like a very, very long time. But moving on to Brave, I have to sadly put Brave at bad. This movie is just not good. I like the whole like lore of it, and I like this whole like Scottish thing going on, but at the end of the day, like once those bear stories come in and all that kind of stuff, it just doesn't really work for me personally. I would honestly go as far as to say that after the first act of this movie, Brave is probably the worst Pixar movie out of the bunch. But moving on to our three movies from the Cars franchise, starting it off with Cars 3, I think Cars 3 goes in the border line good to meh category. Would definitely put it at the bottom of good. Honestly, I do think the Cars movies aren't that bad. I'm a sucker for these movies because I rewatched them over and over and over when I was super little. But Cars 3 was definitely a good movie. It has more of like the Rocky storyline where you're training the youngling and all that kind of stuff, and I think that's a great storyline. But moving on to Cars 2, I think this one is very, very disappointing. I would put this one at the top of the bad category. I don't think it's the worst Pixar movie, but it is really genuinely just not that good. It has McQueen in the back seat of this movie when it shouldn't have that. Mater should not be the forefront of this franchise, and I think Cars 3 did a great job of kind of moving the focus back onto McQueen, but I definitely think that Cars 2 was just a complete misfire from Pixar, especially going off of what Cars 1 did best, which was that Hudson storyline, and that's where we get to Cars 1. I think Cars 1 is a great movie. I don't think it's best of the best just because the best of the best are all-time classics in my opinion, and Cars is borderline there in my opinion, but for now I think great is it'll do. Moving on to Coco, this might be a hot take, but I definitely think this is one of the best of the best.
I would never cry to a Frank Ocean song, let's be honest. I am a man.
I don't know what it is about Coco. It always just pulls on my heartstrings. I remember there was one school year where I watched this movie like 10 times total, and I love it every single time. It's one of the few Pixar movies where I rewatched it over and over and over, but it was like an unwillingly rewatching it, and I still absolutely love this thing. It is easily one of the saddest Pixar movies, and of course, Pixar is known for making us choke up during their movies, and this one definitely does that. Next up is Finding Dory. I think Finding Dory goes at the top of great. I think this is a phenomenal sequel to Finding Nemo, and I know a lot of people find Dory to be a super annoying character because of her memory loss, but I actually think she is a great character, very, very compelling. The otters are super cute, and that one song that plays while the 18-wheeler is flipping is so iconic. We waited so long for this sequel, and it was definitely worth the wait. I definitely think this was well worth a sequel, and overall, it's just a great film. Next up is Finding Nemo. I'm heavily debating on this one. I don't know whether to put it at the very top of great or at the bottom of best of best, but I think for now I'm going to put it at the very, very top of great, but I might move it at the end of this video. Finding Nemo is the classic story of just growing up and learning to let go. I think this movie is absolutely phenomenal in terms of the lessons that can be learned from it, and as a whole, it is probably one of the easiest movies to cry to from Pixar. Next up is Inside Out. I'm super stumped on this one. I think I'm gonna go best of the best, but I think it'll be very bottom of best of the best. I think this is genuinely a near perfect film. I think that the creativity behind this movie is one of the best in any of the Pixar catalog. And that's a big thing to talk about, especially when you're talking about Pixar. A lot of these ideas are super unique, and they come up with a lot of super unique ways to tell different stories. And I think that Inside Out does it the best. I watched Inside Out in theaters, and I remember walking out of it thinking, okay, okay, what if there were people in my head? What would they be acting like? I definitely think that that is a huge creative pro to Inside Out, where it's like a lot of people can just relate to this because everyone has these emotions. And I think it just works really well. And I think it, as a whole, it rounds out the movie to be one of the best of the best because it's so relatable. Okay, next up, we got Luca. I don't really know how I feel about this movie. I definitely think it's a good movie, and I put it above Cars 3. So I do think that it is a good film. I think Luca works there. Luca is definitely a tearjerker towards the end of the movie, but as a whole, I felt like it lacked emotion throughout like the first, I guess, half of this film. But I will also say, I love the unique story of this and how he turns to a fish whenever he has water on him and stuff like that. And also the heartbreak between these two characters is really, really well executed. This movie as a whole, I don't know if it'll stand the test of time as much as movies like Inside Out and Coco did, but I think for now, this is where it's supposed to be. Now, Monsters, Inc. and Monsters University, I think I have a hot take on this one. Now, granted, I have not seen Monsters, Inc. in a pretty long time, and I've seen Monsters University a lot of times, so I think I'm gonna go Monsters, Inc. as the top of good. And I think Monsters University is going to go at the very top of great. This probably is my biggest hot take of this video. I think Monsters University is phenomenal. I think that this is an absolutely awesome movie. I might actually end up moving it to best of the best, just depending on where the rest of these movies go. But Monsters University is an absolutely emotionally filled drive. It is so, so well done. I love the uniqueness in terms of all the different monster designs, all of the different parts of this movie, probably some of the scariest moments in all of Pixar when you have that cabin scene. And just the breakoff between Sully and Mike is some heartbreak that I'll never feel again. Now that I actually think about it more, I think Monsters, Inc. is going to go up just a little bit, kind of put it in front of Cars 1, and I think it's going to enter that great category. But Monsters, Inc., I just don't remember much from it. Haven't seen it in a very, very long time, but I do remember it being a great movie when I did watch it. But next up is Onward, and I think, once again, this is going to be a hot take. Onward is a great movie. Honestly, I think it could go in the great category. It is so, so great. And this was actually the last movie that I watched in theaters before COVID hit, and I didn't get to watch any more movies in theaters until A Quiet Place Part 2. This movie did a really, really great job of kind of encapsulating that bonding experience between two brothers. And at the end, when they sacrifice spending time with their dad and spending time with their brother, I think it's actually a great story point. I honestly don't know what public reception is for this movie. I didn't really hear much about it. So let me know what you think of Onward in the comments down below. Next up on the list is Ratatouille. Now, I don't really know how I feel about this one. As a whole, I do think it goes in the great category, but it's been a little bit since I've seen it. I do think that Ratatouille is probably gonna go right about here. I think in the middle of the great category is pretty valid for it. Honestly, I might have to move Cars. I think I'm gonna move Cars down to just a good, because I don't want too much in the great category. I feel like that it's not really great. I'm just generalizing it too much. Not much else to say about Ratatouille. I just like the movie. It's an enjoyable time. I don't remember many of the emotional points in this movie. Again, I haven't seen it in a while. But next up is Soul. I actually think Soul is a good movie. I think it goes above Cars 3, right under Luca. I think the animation style is really, really cool, and I think honestly a lot of individual aspects of this movie really carry it, and it probably has some of my favorite messages of all of Pixar. And it's really just to value the time that you have on this earth, and it's definitely one of the most versatile messages in all of Pixar. Oof. But next up is The Good Dinosaur. I do not remember much from this movie, and the things I do remember are not good. I think it's gonna go in the middle of the bad category. I think the animation is actually spectacular in this film, and I think it's visually super, super well done. And that's the only thing keeping it from being like the worst movie in my opinion.
All right, guys, I'm editing this video, and like, low key, if you didn't know this was a Pixar movie, you probably wouldn't watch it.
But these next two are phenomenal films. Okay, so we got The Incredibles 2. I think Incredibles 2 is the very, very top of great. And I think The Incredibles is the best of the best. I think, honestly, it goes at the very top for now. The Incredibles, starting off with The Incredibles, it is one of my favorite superhero movies of all time. It is on my top 20 superhero movies of all time list. The Incredibles 2 somehow managed to follow up one of my favorite superhero movies of all time, and it just almost reached that barrier of surpassing it. So speaking a little more on Incredibles 2, I think Incredibles 2 did a phenomenal job of just being a great superhero movie. This is before Avengers, this is before The Dark Knight, this is before all of those other movies, and it does a spectacular job at encapsulating what superheroes are, and I think Syndrome is also a great villain. Not talking about Incredibles 2, I definitely think the villainous side of it is a little bit on the weaker end compared to The Incredibles 1, but I love how Elastigirl is at the forefront here, and overall, I just love how they followed up The Incredibles. I really love how they followed up this world, and after so long, they still kept that magic alive, and for that, I have to give it a lot of props. Now, Turning Red, I think Turning Red is a meh movie. I know a lot of people really liked it, but it's just not something I could really relate to. I don't necessarily think it's the worst thing in the world. That's why I'm not putting it a bad, but I could definitely see though why people really like it. I can understand if you can relate to this story and how much you can really understand these characters and connect with them. Personally, I just really couldn't. Next up, we got the Toy Story franchise. This is one of the best movie franchises of all time, in my opinion. Toy Story 4, I'm still a little bit iffy on, but starting it off with Toy Story 1, this is a great movie. Toy Story 1, I'm definitely going to put it at the top of great. Toy Story 2, I'm going to put it more in the middle of great, but I definitely still think it is a great movie. I think I'm going to put Toy Story 2 right below Finding Dory. But Toy Story 3, and this one might come to a surprise for a lot of you, is one of the best in my opinion. Honestly, I would probably say it is right underneath The Incredibles, my second favorite Pixar movie. Lotso is one of my favorite villains of all time, and it is just absolutely phenomenal. Now, I do want to make some quick changes. I do want to move Monsters, Inc. down to the top of good, as well as Onward to the top of good. Now that I think about it a little bit more, I do think Ratatouille is just another good movie. Again, maybe it's because I haven't seen it in a while, but I think I'm just going to put it right below Onward here. But now into Toy Story 4. I don't really know how I feel about this movie. Even after watching it for the first time, I didn't really have a consensus on it just because it kind of felt like it just existed. After Toy Story 3 being so, so good for me, I don't know. I just wasn't the biggest fan of it. I think I could put it at the top of meh. It tells a cool story, but it doesn't do anything for me, at least compared to Toy Story 3. And next up is Up. I think Up is a great movie. I think a lot of people underrate this one. And I feel like a lot of people just think like, oh, the first act is good. And then after that, nothing much happens. I would completely disagree. I do think it's at the very bottom of great, but I wouldn't even consider it to be just good. Carl and Ellie's story makes me tear up every time. And I absolutely just love this movie. It's action packed. Honestly, it had way more action than I ever expected. And overall, it's just a super unique premise. Next up is WALL-E. I know a lot of people think this one is boring, but I actually like this one a lot. I actually used to like it a lot more in the past, but it's definitely regressed for me over time. I definitely think it's just a good movie, and I think I'd put it above Onward. I think I put it borderline good to great, but again, I don't know what it is. Just over time, I've liked it a little bit less and a little bit less. I think the romance is something that is one of the best in any of the Pixar movies, but other than that, it is slightly just a boring story at times. And finally is the newly released Lightyear. Now, I know a lot of people might be surprised by this one, but I have to put it at the top of great. This is borderline best of the best from Pixar.
I have to interrupt this video and say that my thoughts on the movie have changed a lot now that I'm revisiting it. I recorded this like probably 2 hours after I watched the movie. I was still recovering from that massive twist that I won't be revealing in this video, but all I can say is it has gone down a little bit for me, so I don't think it's the very top of great. I don't think it's borderline best of the best. So my biggest reason for this change is primarily the fact that I definitely think the second act is not as good as I remember. The first act is really good, and the third act is near perfect, and I think I had a lot of bias from just watching that third act that I forgot most of the flaws in the second act, and how the second act was borderline just boring at times. But I will say I still think it's in the great tier, probably near the bottom of the great tier. So you guys won't see it on screen, but again, it'll be near the bottom of the great tier for me. But again, overall, I still really, really like the movie. I think it's a pretty good movie. You can check out my Letterboxd, my full review. I gave it about a 7.5
out of 10. But again, I just wanted to clarify that change because I don't want it to be at the top of the grade tier when it's really not. But I can't make the change in the video, so now you know.
Zurg is absolutely phenomenal. This is probably the best animation we've ever seen in Pixar. The score is absolutely chilling. And the twists and turns that this movie takes, some people might not be a fan of, but I absolutely loved it. And it had my jaw on the floor from the moment that that twist happened to when the credits rolled. And I will say, at times, definitely the story is very basic. It's definitely that ragtag team coming together, but it is just a great movie overall. But yeah, guys, that is my final ranking for all of the Pixar movies. I didn't want to put too much in the best of the best because the best of the best is some of the movies that I consider classics for all of animation. But again, let me know your full ranking for all the Pixar movies in the comments down below. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Peace.